What's up, everyone? Tom from the Airsoft headquarters here, and welcome back. Today, I'm down at the Airsoft Arena in order to show some of you guys some of the training movements that I will utilize for Airsoft and Airsoft only. The way I look at Airsoft training, for me personally, it's a way of meditating, especially if I have a super busy work week. This allows me to set aside an hour or two of my busy days in order to just lower my mental capacity and start from, you know, ground zero and work on fundamentals. So that just allows me to kind of ground myself mentally, at least for me personally. It's also a form of physical endurance. So I'll go through the fundamentals and then I'll start to incorporate some physical exercise before I go through some other movements in order to get some of those awesome gains. And then sometimes I'll just swap it up as far as utilizing different movements and different target scenarios and kind of just work my way up from there. We'll just walk through some of the stuff that I do. Hopefully this educates you guys and maybe inspires you guys to do some airsoft training of yourselves, maybe in your home, in your garage, in your backyard, wherever you can do it. So let's go ahead and do it together. By the way, really sorry if this kind of comes out a little weird as far as audio goes. This is gonna be one of the only clips that I utilize the remote. And then I'm going to go to a soft cattail. And then I'm also gonna be blasting some of my music in the background. So we'll probably have to do some audio over that or at least cut audio so we don't get any copyright strikes. So obviously you're gonna wanna do this in a very safe environment, if preferably under some type of supervision. But always step one is without the magazines loaded up, utilizing safe wear or safe eye protection as well. Step one is always kind of just get yourself warmed up as far as aiming down sights, bring the rifle up to your shoulder, or even transitioning to different shoulders. So just slowly taking your time, finding that ground, moving that stance around, and then either gain a fast snap up or lean in and acquire that target. And like I said, you can work on transitioning shoulders as well. Working on that footwork, however you originally learn it. Obviously, different types of professionals are going to suggest doing it different types of positions within different environments, but just get yourself warmed up. Step two, or part two, of whatever the movements are is pretty basic as well. Since I like to use a gas blowback as far as my more realistic style of rifle platform, but I will still utilize AEGs, if you are using a secondary platform, this would be the time to start practicing transition drills. And so what that looks like is, with my gas blowback rifle, I have the magazine inside of the rifle gassed up with no BBs inside of there. The secondary also is gassed up but had BBs, and the intention being that I will take one shot, which is going to dry fire, and the bolt is going to lock back, at which point I will need to transition again, whatever that looks like, or however you prefer to do it, it'll look that way to you. Then I'll do one shot with the secondary, put it back into the holster, and then transition back to the rifle. Not working on mag reloads just yet. But since the secondary is going to be shooting BBs, you have to make sure that you are wearing your eye protection down on you. If you were working on the base, the previous one, you don't really need to wear eye protection if you're not shooting anything. This time, now you are. At least if you want to go, if you want to work out with me. So, aim down sight, shot, transition, shoot. And then it's back up. Make sense? All right, we're gonna do that for a bit. Remember to take your time. No need to rush. Back to the music.
All right, so now that I feel like I'm good warmed up, now I'm gonna start to put BBs inside of the rifle system. And what I'm going to do is I have my two targets to the left and to the right here. I'm going to be utilizing this as my break point. So for anyone that doesn't know, I like to work both right and left-handed to be as ambidextrous as possible. So what I'm going to intend to do with this movement is lean right, pretend like this all here is cover, engage this target, and then I'm going to transition and engage this target. Working on that muzzle control, pointing it downward as I start to transition, or going up, if you prefer to go up, I find it more comfortable to go down and around. We're gonna treat this like a friendly or an objective, and just be aware of where my muzzle is pointed. You probably saw me transition this, and that's just more using if this itself was a obstacle and not an actual individual. So we're gonna treat this like an individual, and we're going to work on right hand muscle control, left hand muscle control, right hand. And even still, up to this point, we haven't been concerned as to where our BBs are going, and we're still not. The point being is to get BBs down range and get used to where those BBs are flying, at least compared to where we're standing. So we're not going to care about where the BBs are impacting just yet. Alright, so what's next is we're going to be trying to do different elevation and shooting from those different elevations. Swapped out for an AEG because I guess, I know does not like to make those sudden adjustments within the magazines. So we're going to stick with the battery powered system. So for this, we're going to utilize one target and then two other targets farther down the range. So we're going to engage one with our muzzle right above the top one, and then we're going to drop and engage the secondary target. And then we're gonna come up, engage the first one, drop down, number two, one, two, one, two. And then, to swap it up again, to work on my ambi awesomeness, we're gonna do one, two, one, two. And that was a little hard for me, so I'm gonna go a little slow. I think you guys understand it, so let's go ahead and do it. But first, music.
Look at that, perspiration, but no fogging up the goggles. They work.
Alright, this is where it's going to start to get fun. So I currently have a triangle, target, target, target. At which case, I will take my AEG MP5, and I will shoot and move towards the target. Once I reach the target, then I will move and start to engage the other one. And then once I reach that target, just shooting and moving towards that target and engaging. It doesn't have to be super fast, but slow, controlled bursts. This is one where we can start to get the heart rate down, but my muscles are a little fatigued, so we're gonna have to really work at that fine lower control to get those shots to start to impact. Here's where we're gonna start to care when those BBs are impacting, when our muscles are fatigued, and we need to make those shots count the most. So let's get into it. I'm going to make sure to stock up on a couple of magazines before I do. Another great thing about doing physical exercise with your airsoft gear is that you, one, wear it in, two, know how to handle and manipulate it, again, with that fatigued body, and then number three, you know your capabilities, and then you can continually grow as far as what you're able to do, you know, every time you physically exercise. You know, I have to brag or nothing, but when Wisconsin was under quarantine, started working out fairly heavily. Then a year later, or when we got out of quarantine actually, not even a year later, when we got out of quarantine in July or August, I had lost 40 pounds. So I believe you guys can do it too. Understand your body, you know what you're able to do when it comes down to muscle fatigue, worn out, tired. Again, don't push yourself. If you push yourself, you become a medical casualty. Heat stroke, dehydrated, just overworked. You don't want to get there. But as long as you know where your threshold is, then you can have as much fun as possible. Or at least understand how long you can have fun. We'll put it that way. Oh, quick breather, but let's get back to it. Oh, keep it going. Something we need to talk about, because I do not see enough people utilizing this very basic technique down at the airsoft arena. And that is the simple technique of being able to look down a corridor or a hallway or a section of the field that you want to look towards. The most common type of peeking is when you are behind a piece of cover and want to be able to identify any type of information, whether it be players or objectives that are down this hallway. Now, the first three problems that I see is that players will peek with these three following methods. Like one, or like that. Like this, number two, or even number three. Those three ways to peek a corner is the fastest way to get shot in the face without being able to shoot back immediately. Instead, what you need to do is you need to think of this corner as a pie. Now imagine, despite this corner of a building being square, think of it more as a circle. This corner right here, this 90 degree, is going to be the center of the pie. And the pie you know, has cuts away from the center of the pie. If you cut your pie into squares, you're an animal. I'll let you know that right now. So your pie is cut into small triangles. And obviously the most common location to be peeking would be behind a type of cover like so. So what you're going to do is, with your imaginary pie here, you're going to make sure I was recording. You're going to cut one slice of the pie. You're going to cut another slice of the pie, and you're going to cut another slice of the pie. Slow, smooth cuts in order to get all the way around and check wherever you want to be looking towards. Now there's a couple of tips that I would say people should be utilizing is when it comes to this, favor leaning in the direction that you want to cut that pie. Also, utilize whatever hand you are cutting with. So if this is a right-hand corner, you should be using a right-hand dominant type of holding technique, keeping your elbow tucked in and obviously leaning into where you are cutting in order to keep your legs away from that line of fire as well. The exact same thing can be said for any type of left-hand corners like I have here. Utilize left-hand movements. Keep that leg tucked in. Keep that elbow tucked in. It makes smooth, slow cuts. Now, when it comes to a cut, the reason why you want to physically cut a corner is to identify the targets that are eye level as well as below eye level. That way you can see absolutely everything and have everything within your line of fire. That is the most basic type of technique and method in order to as thoroughly cut a corner or peek a corner as possible. The reason you want to do this is because, one, if you do have an enemy in your line of fire, either here or here or here, your barrel is on him. And now you can pull that trigger and you can engage him. Versus peeking with the first three methods, can't really do that because your gun is down or way back behind you. A little harder to do that, right? Now, as you progress in your technique of peeking a corner, you're gonna have different styles. Being airsoft, there's no recoil, so you can put your rifle up to your shoulder, even put it over it like a paintball gun, and you can tie a corner like this. This also puts as little profile of your person on you. However, this is not a stable shooting platform. This is a stable shooting platform. Now I have 3 points of contact on my rifle. This shoulder, B3, is not really a point of contact. So as you see any of us more advanced players, when we pike corners or peek a corner, we tend to do everything at a mid ready or a high ready. That way we can do a quick snapshot or even do a quick peek. Because here's the thing, you can peek like this. You don't even need to do any type of cut because now I can come here and I can identify there's an enemy and there's a Starbucks cup. That enemy down there, he's a basic bitch. Look at that, he got a Frappuccino. What a dum-dum. And now I can shoot him and I can engage him. Really, really easy. Versus this punk. Ow, that hurt! Right? You could even get into it as far as put your foot forward. And you see that I'm stepping away from the corner. I'm not all the way up to it because guess what? I can see only this, but the enemies can see my flashlight or any other part of side profile of my rifle, which indicates them that I'm going to be peeking like this. So staying back and then doing those slow cuts. You can even come down to the corner here and you can lean out. If you have a low angle, I know that I'm in the bottom corner of the frame there, but if you're down here, you already have a low profile and you don't need to do as deep of cuts. So you can have a low ready and then snap up to engage. That is another kind of technique. But make sure to peek a corner properly, do other research to see what other people suggest as far as peaking, because the first three methods to peak a corner will not do it, won't cut it. I really don't want to see people peeking corners like that, because again, they get shot in the face and then they complain to me. Let's get on with it. The most important piece of advice that I think I've ever received when I started airsofting was shoot and move. So what that looks like, or at least what it should look like in practice, is when you peek a corner and you get engagement, engage for only a couple shots. You don't need to stick around long enough to verify if he's been hit or not, and then move to a new location. Always checking to make sure that you have your angles of engagement covered and you have a rough idea as to where they are. I can't tell you how many times I thought I was good and in cover, and then lo and behold, I get hit through a sliver, 2-inch sliver of space that a BB could pass through. So always check your angles of engagement, shoot and move, and so we're gonna do some, or at least I am going to do some physical movements where I'm going to start over here. Engage and target. Fast move. Doesn't have to be a full-on sprint. Over to a completely different corner. I'm going to be using my zoom camera as well as my helmet mounted GoPro to show you what I'm moving, because on that tripod and trying to move it back and forth, it's going to be really exhausting. So. We'll do shoot and move now. We'll do shoot and move. I'm getting exhausted, can you tell? Feels good.
A little closer than I thought. Oh God! I know that I keep saying that gas blowbacks for Wisconsin are not good. However, I really want a gas blowback MP5. The problem is that there are none in the US, at least as far as ones that are supposed to be here from VFC Umarex Elite Force. But I really want a gas blowback MP5 for some reason.
So I accidentally put myself in one of the worst situations for myself as a shooter. Not myself as an individual, but as a shooter where I'm trying to shoot and move. You guys can see from that camera the target way down there. I, however, on the other hand, with the help of my zoom camera, I can break the plane of this wall. So I am looking right down the wall here, but I can't physically see it. And the only way I can see that target is if I make the commitment to step out of my cover, and then I can start to engage. Now I know I'm over exaggerating the step, but the point being that if I'm high like I'm supposed to be, I'm still safe here in cover. But as soon as I start to come out here, then that becomes an issue. So I, as a player, now need to commit to moving to the next piece of cover and being sure that I have all my fundamentals in check so I can step out and impact him really quickly. I know I stepped out of line for you guys, but I think you guys get the idea.
See, not invisible right there. As soon as I come over here, hide this, and now he's right there. And he's visible right there as well. See him? That's a hard angle for me. This here is a strong corner for me because of this pillar. I can tuck in right here, have cover from behind me, but the trade-off is that now I need to come real close to the corner, like I said not to. But I can snap that, come back, hide this. Oop. Watch and make sure that my hands aren't in that line of fire. See how awkward this is? If I step forward, now I can hit him, and the majority of my body is now within cover from the left-hand side here. If I step back, now there's angles here and here. And then have my gun up. Nothing there, but I know right there. See, as soon as I got here and was gauging him, I could get contact from over here as well. So I need to engage, impact, move back immediately, go back to clearing corners, and checking, tying everything. I feel my biceps starting to tear apart. Oh, battery died. Oh, that was perfect. I was gonna hit there anyway. Oh, 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 oh. Oh my god. And that's it. That's talent. Mental failure. Oh. That was a good 4 hours. Okay. I try to make a legitimate ending. Oh my good camera. Alright. I'll see you guys over there.
And that concludes Talon's training for today. Obviously, these are only a couple of techniques and movements that I alone implement in my free time. Obviously, do some more research, see what other people are suggesting or doing in their own training exercises or their own movements, or even what other people suggest. That allows you to get the most amount of content as well as have the widest range of techniques available within your arsenal, so you can be the most dynamic and the most adaptable within any type of environment. So if you guys do have any further questions as to what I did or why I did, put them down in the comments section below. I'll answer them to the best of my abilities. And then Please don't ask as far as training here goes. This is just me private time. Since I am one of the managers here, I do have the key, so that is a special privilege that I have. So I will not open it up, will not be opening it up to private play or private training, whatever. So arena only open Friday, Saturday, Sunday, but I do all of my training here so you guys can see exactly what I'm doing with this physical space that is provided. So when you guys do come here during open play, you can utilize those same techniques and movements for your own gameplay. And that's what we get here for today. I'm gonna go home and relax and do some work. So you guys take care, stay safe, stay positive, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.